then I get heartburn. So it's like, you know, all the fun things. And it's funny because I feel like sometimes we forget like how crazy it is, and then you get pregnant again and you do it again and you're like, oh my gosh, how did I forget about all this, you know? Hey guys, welcome back. I'm sitting down and actually doing an actual sit down pregnancy video. My lighting is kind of crazy. My blinds are right there. You can see the reflection, and I'm just gonna make it work today. So welcome. If you guys are new, my name's Jamie. I am one day away from being 38 weeks pregnant, and so I figured I'd sit down and do my pregnancy vlog today. And yeah, so I'm 38 weeks pregnant, you guys. I can't even believe that. And on one hand, I'm like in shock that I'm this far along. On the other hand, I'm like, yes, I feel like I'm 38 weeks pregnant. I feel miserable. And then a little bit of panic comes through me because I'm like, okay, wait, have I dedicated enough time and energy to prepare for her? Like, you know, and this is my fourth pregnancy. So it's not like this is like new to me. It's not like this is just like something that I've never gone through before, right? But it's always a little bit like I'm going through my checklist in my head. I should probably write that down on paper. At my last appointment, I had mentioned to you guys, my midwife had said that Ingrid was kind of sunny side up. To be absolutely correct about what she told me, Ingrid was faced sideways. So her back was towards the side of me and her face was towards like the inside of my thigh. And optimal baby presentation is face down. So face towards your bottom and then back up towards the top of your stomach. She said that was probably what was causing me so much back pain. So I went home, I did like my spinning babies. I got on all fours and looked ridiculous and tried to get her to move out of the position that she was in. And she did move. And then she went right back to where she was at. In the middle of the night when I'm sleeping, I don't know if it's just, I'm thinking that it's like structurally how I'm made, because my two boys, and I'm pretty sure Fiona did the same thing, I had so much back pain. And I feel like they just, like, she just likes to be nestled in that position. She's on her side, and no matter how many times I move her, she goes right back there. But it is nice because I feel like I'm a little bit more aware of my body now, in the sense that when I am getting back pain, I know she's moved into that position, and then I can get on all fours and kind of try to maneuver her or encourage her into like a better position. When I was pregnant with Jude, actually I think it was in my birth story that I talked about this, he was faced sideways inside of me, which actually stalled out my labor, and I was at like 5 centimeters and ended up going home from the hospital because he was just not in a good position. And I'm like, she's doing the same exact thing. So please pray that she doesn't like stay like this. If you guys remember watching my pregnancy vlogs with Ezra, my oldest son, he tore me real bad when he came out, and I had a water birth that was not really planned, not like a planned water birth. And I'm almost positive he came out facing sideways, and that's why he tore me the way that he tore me, which would explain the tearing that I got from him, and then which would explain the prodromal labor and just pain that I've had throughout these last 3 pregnancies with all of my babies sitting the exact same way inside of my body. So I've kind of just come to terms with it, and I'm hoping that when we do go into labor, little miss will get the memo and she will go into a better position. I have had the worst restless legs. And I mentioned this in my last update, but I have been just tossing and turning at nighttime. I was watching Ashley from Joyful Chaos in her last pregnancy with Hazel. I'll link below for you guys, but she had mentioned that she calls it the rotisserie chicken at nighttime, just like turning from one side to another, from one side and to another. And so I laugh, like, because that's totally how I am right now. I'm just like so uncomfortable, and I'm just turning from one side to another at night. And so sleep has really been crazy. I have woken up more times than not and just said, screw it, I'm gonna go clean something, or I'm gonna go get something done that I can't do when my kids are awake, because I'm not sleeping right now and I'm just making myself miserable. I have tried magnesium citrate. I have taken Epsom salt baths. I have stretched my, I've done all this, and I have had this in all my pregnancies, really bad restless leg at the end. I will say one thing that seems to help is if I prop my butt up and kind of make it so that my pelvis is tilted toward me a little bit, it kind of takes some of the pressure off of my legs and off of the inside of my cervix and my nerves and all that area. And so I think that helps just because she's more towards me, more towards like my belly versus my cervix. But it's so uncomfortable at that point too, that if she's not like down engaged where she normally is, and I try to move and I try to like let gravity pull her up a little bit and lean back, then I get heartburn. So it's like, you know, all the fun things. And it's funny because I feel like sometimes we forget like how crazy it is, and then you get pregnant again and you do it again and you're like, oh my gosh, how did I forget about all this, you know? I don't have any idea of when she's going to come. My sons came right around their due date, like days within their due date. Ezra was a couple days early, Jude was one day early. My actual labor started 2 days early for him, but then I stalled out because of his fabulous position. So he was one day early. Fiona was randomly like almost 2 weeks early, but she was my first, and so I don't know if like their measurements were correct or my due date, or you know, so she could have been closer to her due date and I didn't know, because she was born 7/15. She was born like almost 8 pounds, and she was, to their calculation, 2 weeks early, so I have no idea. So I am thinking that she will come around her due date. I'm only 2 weeks out from that, and so I'm mentally trying to tell myself, 2 weeks is not a long time. You can do this. I'm trying to just focus on other things, but it is hard. Like every time you get like a little twinge or a little something or other, you're like, oh, am I going into labor, you know? And even with your fourth baby, you still do that. Like I thought I'd be like, oh, I'm past that. I'm not gonna do that this time, but I'm still doing it. And then, you know, trying to keep up with my three little kids who are 5, almost 4, and 2, is insane. Like I'm trying to bend over and pick toys up. I'm trying to homeschool them right now. And I just feel like this really large Michelin man trying to take care of them, but it's all part of the process, you know? And pretty soon she'll be here and it will be in a whole nother season of, you know, a different kind of sleepless nights and, you know, trying to figure out what her personality is like and learning all that kinds of stuff too. So that's not foreign to me. I know that's coming as well. I'm still having a lot of Braxton Hicks. Oh, one thing that I've been having is I've been getting hot flashes, which I didn't have with my other pregnancies. At least I don't remember. And I just get all of a sudden super, super hot. I have to open up all the windows. And it's like 50 degrees outside in Michigan right now in the fall. But I've just been getting crazy, crazy hot flashes. My face is starting to look a little bit fuller. It feels fuller. Looking back at some of my other pregnancy vlogs at this time, I feel like I'm a little bit more swollen in those vlogs than I am in this one and for this pregnancy. And so I don't know. But I feel fuller. I feel like these last 2 weeks are the time when you look at someone and you're like, oh girl, you pregnant. So yeah, that is my 38-week pregnancy vlog. I'm gonna actually be able to do a live belly shot for you guys and stand up and show you guys what little Miss Ingrid looks like. I've got some sweet pajama pants on because they're like the only thing that fit me and don't cut off my circulation underneath my stomach. So enjoy these Christmassy pajama pants. I will see you guys for hopefully 39 weeks. And keep you guys updated. If you don't follow me on Instagram, I do update on Instagram quite often. I don't really do Twitter or Facebook. There's just too many things, too many social media stuff. I hope you guys are doing good, and I will see you next time. Bye.